test your recall with high school students on the Interscholastic Quiz Program, Answers Please. Today's contest brings together Street Academy and Keveny Memorial.
Welcome, everybody, to another edition of Answers, Please. I'm Tim Welch. Today, two Albany County schools, one the Street Academy of Albany and Keveny Academy of Cohoes. First, I'd like to introduce the challengers, Keveny Academy.
The captain is?
Matt Maron, Jr.
George Sweeney, Sr.
Kathleen Tremblay, Sr.
Jimmy McDonald, Sr.
Keveny Academy. Back for their second time here on Answers Please, a winner last week in our first contest between two crosstown rivals. The Street Academy of Albany defeated the Albany Academy for Boys, and their captain is?
Chuck Miller, Sr.
Boyette Lloyd, Sr.
Alfreda Tillman, Sr.
Vivi Williams, Jr.
The Street Academy of Albany. Before we let you in on some of the not-so-complicated rules for playing this game, I'd like to point out that the game itself is meant not to be a measure of the strength of the individual programs at the schools represented here, but rather to be a measure of the quick recall capable of on the part of the students who are participating. So, without further ado, here's how we play the game.
There are two types of questions, toss-up questions worth 5 points each, and four-part team questions worth a possible 20 points, 5 points for each part. Each round of the game proceeds as follows. Toss-up questions are offered to both teams. The first team to correctly answer three toss-up questions earns the right to a four-part team question. At the conclusion of each of these team questions, the round is completed and a new round begins. The team with the greater number of points at the end of the game is declared the winner. Prize money will be awarded each week as follows. The winning school will receive $50. The runner-up school will receive $25. Should a school win three consecutive games, they will be retired as undefeated champions and awarded a handsome trophy provided by the Junior College of Albany. Now, answers please.
The first buzzer question is worth 5 points. I will read you several definitions for one word. As soon as you recognize that word, which fits all the definitions, please interrupt me. To spring with a quick plunging leap. To charge against something. Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
Dive?
No.
Would you like me to complete the question? All right. To spring with a quick plunging leap. To charge against something. A dandy. A dollar. A male animal as a deer or an antelope. Jim McDonald of Keveny.
Buck.
Yes, buck. Second buzzer questions. All buzzer questions in the first half are worth 5 points. Dwight Eisenhower was the president of the United States when Alaska became a state. Who was president when Alaska was purchased? Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
McKinley?
No.
Matt Maron of Keveny.
Polk?
No.
Andrew Johnson. 1867 was the date of the purchase. He was president then, right after the Civil War. For another 5 points, most ships carry several flags. The ensign or national flag, a swallow-tailed pennant called a burgee. But what kind of ship carries a Jolly Roger? Keveny. George Sweeney.
A pirate ship.
A pirate ship, yes. Jolly Roger, of course, a skull and crossbones. For another 5 points. In poker, a hand containing a pair of aces and a pair of eights. Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
It's called the dead man's hand?
Yes. I'm sorry, I can't accept that. That was another part of the question. That is not the answer. I'm sorry, I can't accept that. I'll complete. The pair of aces and the pair of eights is known as a dead man's hand. Who was holding this hand when he was killed, Keveny? Matt Maron.
Wild Bill Hickok.
Wild Bill Hickok, yes. That entitles you to a team question, the general topic of which is alphabet words. You'll have 30 seconds to answer all four questions. You'll have 5 points for each one. There are several words in the English language which are homophones or sound alikes for letters of the alphabet. For instance, a little stinger is a bee. Start the clock. Matt? A noisy, bright-colored bird remotely related to crows.
Jay?
Yes. George, an extension at right angles to a building, a wing.
T.
No. Kathy, a child's perpetual question.
Why?
Yes. Jim, ocular perception or the organ for it.
I.
Yes. George, yours was L. E-L-L. Letter L. Okay, that gives you a total of 30 points. Street Academy of Albany has yet to score, but here's another buzzer question worth 5 points. Who is the biblical king whose son, Jonathan, was a great friend of David? Matt Merrin of Keveny.
Saul.
Yes, King Saul. Ishmael. For another 5 points, another buzzer question. How old must one be before he can be elected a senator? Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
30?
Yes, 30 years old. Another buzzer question, 5 points. What does RBI mean in a... Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
Runs batted in?
Runs batted in a baseball score, yes. Another buzzer question. When it is noon in New York City, what time is it in Los Angeles? Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
9 a.m.?
9 a.m., yes. Now you, Street Academy of Albany, have entitled yourself to a team question, the topic of which is largest cities. You'll have 40 seconds to answer all four questions. You'll have 5 points for each correct answer. We usually are looking for the capitals of various states. Now I am interested in the largest city in each state I name. Start the clock. Chuck, Alaska.
Anchorage?
Yes. Star, Colorado.
Denver?
Yes. Frida, Louisiana. Candy, Texas.
Arkansas.
No. It's Houston, Texas, New Orleans, Louisiana. Okay? You got 2 out of 4. We'll go on to more buzzer questions. As you know, we have to build to 3 correctly answered buzzer questions before a team qualifies for a team question. Let's start building buzzers. It is mentioned in the Fifth Amendment to the Constitution and states that have that no person shall be tried twice for the same crime. What is this clause most... Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
Double jeopardy?
Double jeopardy, yes. The Constitution states, nor shall any person be subject for the same offense to be twice put in jeopardy of life or limb. That's the specific reading in the Constitution. Another 5-point buzzer question. What palindromic word, that is a word which reads the same forwards and backwards, means pertaining to citizens, city, or citizenship? Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
Civic?
Civic, yes. Another buzzer question. What frontiersman carried a rifle nicknamed Old Betsy? Keveny Memorial, Jim McDonald.
Daniel Boone?
No. Anyone from Street Academy of Albany? I completed the question. Chuck Miller.
Davy Crockett?
Yes, Davy Crockett. Again, you have qualified for a team question. The general subject heading, initial words. 40 seconds for all 4 questions, 5 points for each correct answer. I will read you a set of initials which are abbreviations for longer expressions. Please give me the expressions. Start the clock. Chuck, IQ.
Intelligence quotient.
Yes. Star, USSR.
Russia, Soviet, pass.
Frida, HUD, H-U-D.
Pass.
And Candy, C-I-O.
Pass.
That was Union of Soviet Socialist Republics, USSR, Housing and Urban Development, HUD, and Congress of Industrial Organization, CIO. You got one of them. Is that halftime? So quickly? Time flies when you're having fun. The score at this point is 45-35. Street Academy of Albany in the lead by 10 points. Now let's, before we take time out for a halftime message, I'd like you to meet some of the people from Keveny Academy who are here as challengers today. Their captain is Matt Marin, who is the only junior on the squad. Matt, tell me something about Keveny Academy.
Well, Keveny Academy is a sort of a small Catholic school in Cohoes.
What do you mean by sort of small? What about the student body?
About 300.
Okay. And we're really appreciating the opportunity to come here and
speak
and
about
tell about your school.
It's a pretty fine school.
Oh, good.
I must evaluate it. Yeah.
Good luck in the second half. I want to talk to some of the seniors about what they're going to be doing in September of this year. George Sweeney?
Hopefully I'll be attending Siena College.
Is there any question at this point?
Well, I'm working on finance right now.
That's becoming an increasingly dangerous problem as people go on to school and try to borrow money in a difficult economy. Good luck to you. What subject area might you pursue?
I'm not really sure right now.
Okay. Kathy Tremblay, you are also a senior.
Mm-hmm.
What are your plans for September?
Well, I plan to go to the Culinary Institute in Hyde Park to study culinary arts.
I understand that's one of the finest schools on the East Coast for...
Yes, I'm really looking forward to it.
Culinary arts. Mm-hmm. Well, very good. Good luck to you. You must be an excellent cook already. Jim McDonald, you two are a senior, and you will be going where in September?
I'm going to Rochester Institute of Technology for photo illustration.
RIT, excellent technical school. Have you already been accepted?
Yeah, I've been accepted.
Is this normally the time of the year when you start getting acceptances from colleges?
I got accepted in November.
Oh, you were?
You had to apply early.
Early admission.
Yeah, well, so, rotating, whatever.
You don't want to leave those kinds of things to chance.
That's true.
All right.
Exactly what I said.
Good luck to all of you, especially in the second half of this contest. Before we take time out for that message, though, I'd like to reintroduce Chuck Miller, the captain of the Street Academy of Albany team, who will tell us about some of those people behind the scenes who have helped make him and his so sharp.
Well, our coach is Peter Bowen. His assistants are Bill Newman and Al Brown. And our alternates are Larry Richardson, Moses Clark, Regina Wright, and Chris Leininger.
Very good. Good luck to you all in the second half. And we'll play the second half of Answers Please right after this. I'd like to point out before we begin the second half that the point totals are doubled for each correct answer. Each correct answer will now be worth 10 points as we begin the second half of Answers Please. The score... 45-35, Street Academy of Albany in the lead. For 10 points, this buzzer question. What American composer was called the March King? Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
John Philip Sousa.
John Philip Sousa, yes. For another 10, taking into consideration only the Atlantic coastline, which eastern state has the longest coastline? Matt Marin of Keveny Memorial.
South Carolina?
No. Street Academy of Albany. Chuck Miller.
Florida?
Florida, 580 miles. North Carolina is second with 301 miles of coastline. For 10 points, what is the number of the amendment to the United States Constitution which gives women the right to vote? Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
The 19th Amendment?
19th, yes. It's that happy time again. Team question time. Man words. M-A-N words. 40 seconds to answer all of them. 40 points now for correctly answering all four questions. I will give you definitions, the answers to which will contain the word man. Sometimes it may be part of another word. For instance, if I defined a raving lunatic, the answer would be maniac. Start the clock, please. Chuck? A facing of stone, wood, or marble above a fireplace?
Mantle?
Yes. Star. Handcuffs? Frida. Clothing model in store windows?
Mannequin.
Yes. Candy, public official under the Chinese Empire.
Pass.
Mandarin, and yours was manacles for handcuffs. Okay. You got 20 points out of that one. Once again, we build to three correctly answered buzzer questions. Here's the first one on our way to that. In the Battle of Chancellorsville during the Civil War, what famous Southern general was killed by shots fired in error? Street Academy of Albany, Chuck Miller.
Stonewall Jackson.
Stonewall Jackson. Shot by his own men. May 1863. Another buzzer question. 10 points now. When a soundtrack is changed from its original language to another, what do we call this process? Keveny Memorial Academy, Jim McDonald.
Dubbing in.
Dubbing, yes. Another 10-point buzzer. Think carefully, because the answer to this question is not obvious. Which state is the easternmost of the United States, taking into account longitude? Jim McDonald of Keveny.
I didn't buzz. Honest, I didn't.
I'm sorry? Kathy. I'm sorry, Kathy, I didn't see you.
Alaska?
Alaska, yes. The island of Attu is across the 180th parallel, so it is east rather than west. Little tricky question there. We love those here on Answers, Please. This American state capital has a famous mountain named because its volcanic crystals make it reflect like a diamond. What? Chuck Miller of Street Academy of Albany.
Hawaii's Diamond Head?
Diamond Head, Honolulu. I'm sorry, we had to have the capital. We'll have to throw that question out. Another buzzer question. What color optical description applies to Susan's peas and people who walk into doors? Keveny Memorial Academy, Matt Merrin.
Green?
No. Street Academy, Chuck Miller.
Black-eyed?
Black-eyed, yes. Black-eyed Susans, black-eyed peas, and black-eyed people who walk into doors. Although this island has 840,000 square miles, 708,000 of them are covered. Chuck Miller, Street Academy of Albany.
Greenland?
Greenland, yes. Covered with ice, they are. And you have qualified for yet another team question, the topic of which is Indians. 50 seconds, a little more time than normal, and 40 points to answer all of the questions. We are looking for information concerning American Indians. Listen carefully so that you will supply the correct answer. Start the clock. Number one, Chuck. This Indian league consisted of the Mohawk, Onondaga, Oneida, Cayuga, Seneca, and later the Tuscarora tribes. What was its name?
Iroquois?
Yes. Star Lloyd. Originally nomadic, this tribe learned farming and sheep herding from Pueblo neighbors. At present, it is the largest tribe in the United States. Who? Okay. Frida, this Great Plains tribe was led by Sitting Bull and defeated Custer.
Aztecs?
No. And Candy, the five civilized tribes of the southeast were the Cherokees, Choctaws, Chickasawa, and Creeks. What was the name of the other of these southeastern Indians?
Pass.
Seminoles. Seminoles, Sioux, Navajo. All right. Okay, the score at this point, 135 to 55. A lot more questions to go through. For 10 points, the 23rd Amendment to the United States Constitution was of particular interest to one section of the United States. Why? Matt Merrin of Keveny Memorial.
The South, because of civil rights.
No. Street Academy of Albany. Any takers? Chuck Miller.
South, because it barred the poll tax.
No. The District of Columbia, because it gave them electors for the presidential election. That was the 23rd Amendment, one of the more recent ones. Nothing lost, nothing gained. Some words have several meanings. I will give you all the meanings for one word. Please give me the word as soon as you recognize it. The medium for transmission of sound waves. The outward appearance of a person or thing. A melody. A tune. The guess. Kathy Tremblay of Keveny.
Air?
Air, yes. Listen again carefully to several definitions I will give you for one word. When you recognize the word, stop me. An expression of greeting, showing praise, to hurl forcibly, to some... Kathy Tremblay, Keveny.
Hello?
No. I'll repeat it for you, Street Academy. An expression of greeting, showing praise, to hurl forcibly, to salute, and small lumps of ice that fall from high clouds. Chuck Miller.
Hail?
Yes. Another 10-point buzzer question. The lack of what vitamin leads to the disease rickets? Matt Merrin, Keveny.
D?
Yes, vitamin D. Tocopherols is the name of the vitamin. Which of these cities is west of the Mississippi River? Memphis, Shreveport. Matt? Yes. Memphis, Shreveport, or Biloxi were the choices. You have qualified for a team question, the general topic of which is courts and law. 50 seconds, 40 points. All questions have a legal twist. Listen carefully. Start the clock. Matt, when the orders of a judge are disobeyed, what is the legal term?
Contempt.
Yes. George, what Latin term is used to describe an order to a court officer to bring the arrested person to court to hear the charges against him?
Habeas corpus.
Yes. Kathy, what do we call the science of law and its administration?
Criminal justice.
I can't accept that. Jim, when a lawyer feels that the defendant could not secure a fair trial in one locality, what does he ask for?
A mistrial.
No. Change of venue. And yours, jurisprudence. Okay? We got two for 20 points. Let's keep going. Another 10 points. The name of the state is derived from the Spanish for red or tinted. Matt Merrin, Keveny.
California?
No. Chuck Miller, Street Academy.
Florida?
Colorado. In which direction does a barometer's indicator move to indicate an improvement in the weather? Chuck Miller, Street Academy of Albany.
Moves to higher numbers. Goes up.
We'll accept up, clockwise or upward, yes. What four-word phrase has appeared on every U.S. coin minted since 18... Chuck Miller, Street Academy. Mr. Chance.
In God we trust.
In God we trust. Yes. 10 points. What is the name of that imaginary line which is latitude... Star Lloyd.
Equator.
The equator, yes. Latitude zero, of course. Another team question. Military academies, 40 seconds, 40 points. We are interested in the state location of four of the United States military academies. Be sure to name the state. Start the clock. Chuck. United States Naval Academy.
Maryland.
Yes. Annapolis. United States Air Force Academy. Star.
Pass.
United States Coast Guard Academy. Freedom.
California.
I'm sorry.
California.
No. United States Merchant Marine Academy. Candy.
Pass.
Merchant Marine. Kings Point, New York. Coast Guard. New London, Connecticut. Colorado Springs, Colorado. U.S. Air Force Academy. Another buzzer question. We're flat out of time. And we'll be back to validate the final score, which seems to be decisive, right after this. For the second time in as many weeks, Street Academy of Albany has been victorious, this time over Keveny Memorial Academy of Cohoes. Dr. Ted Murphy of the Junior College of Albany has validated that score.
Tim, there was another big second half by the Street Academy, and certainly Keveny played very well. We're going to send him $25 and nice T-shirts from Channel 6 and wish them a good game and wish Street Academy more success in the future, too.
And they will be your size. We promise that.
We guarantee that.
Good luck to both teams and their futures. Good luck to Street Academy of Albany next week when they'll be back to face another team on Answers Please. Join us then.